Hey guys, I'm Dr. Jason Barker with the Natural Athletes Clinic. And when we talk about supplements, that can mean hundreds of different compounds, things like vitamins, minerals, amino acids, botanical medicines, nutraceuticals, the list goes on and on and on. So I want to kind of break a few of these down over the next series of videos. And today I want to talk about adaptogenic botanical medicines, otherwise known as adaptogens. Now, adaptogens do a lot of what their name sounds like, and that is they help you adapt to stressors. So a more specific definition is that adaptogens help increase a state of non-specific resistance in the body, and they also decrease your sensitivity to stressors. So what does that mean? Well, stress comes in many different forms, as you know. So stress can be mental, emotional, or it can be physical. It really doesn't matter because that stress gets in your brain, and that's how your brain perceives it. And then your brain carries out its functions in helping you deal with the stressors. So adaptogens help limit how stress affects you. Now, interesting, the research behind a lot of the adaptogens began back in the World War II era, when the Soviets were looking at ways that they could help their soldiers persevere and survive in adverse environments. And then, of course, the scientists took their cues from the indigenous people who had been using adaptogens for the last probably hundreds, if not thousands of years. So there are seven main adaptogens that we want to think about. And the first one is Rhodiola. There's Astragalus, Ashwagandha, Cordyceps, Schisandra, Panax Ginseng, and Eleutherococcus, which is also sometimes billed as Siberian Ginseng. Now, when we look at all of the studies on adaptogens, they, of course, all fall under the heading of how do these help the physiology of a person decrease or limit the effects of stress on it. Now, interestingly, some of these studies have started to look at how endurance athletes fare using them, and especially a lot of studies have been done using rhodiola and endurance athletes. And now there's a common thread with the rhodiola studies and athletes, and that is that we know that adaptogens, and especially rhodiola, can help endurance athletes perform at higher intensities for a longer amount of time, and also helps us recover more quickly with fewer side effects. Now, interestingly, in a couple of these studies too, we've also seen increases in max VO2. So that's really a big deal. Now, are all the studies positive with adaptogens and especially rhodiola? No, they're not. Many of them are equivocal too, showing that there were no changes in athletes who use these. However, I would just remind you of the very, very small window by which victory is won, right? So think about the Olympics. When we see people getting a gold medal, or the difference between a gold medal and no medal is just hundredths of a second, a misfire of a muscle, not enough burst of power at the end there. So one thing to remember with the adaptogens is that they have a very, very wide margin of safety and very, very few reports of adverse side effects. So I feel like these are very safe, and I feel like they're something that every endurance athlete should incorporate into their training regimen just because of the potential, the benefit of how it decreases your sensitivity to stress and how your organism or your physiology perceives that stress. And remember, stress is essentially us worrying about things that aren't necessarily going on yet. So a lot of our stress today exists in the mental emotional realm. So if we can save that energy and put it more towards your training and more towards your adaptation to the training changes, you're going to wind up probably having a better experience as an athlete. Now, in the clinic, I see a lot of athletes, or even just people who've been stressed out, who I put on a trial of different adaptogens, and they come back and they always say the same thing. I feel a lot more balanced. I feel like I can tolerate the stressors better, or I'm not as thrown off by the stresses. So I would really encourage you, again, to use these in your regimen. Now, you can start using adaptogens maybe like 2 or 3 weeks prior to the big event, a big race, or even a big training block. And of course, they're very helpful in the off season too. Even when you're not training, but you've got a lot of life stress going on, you can go ahead and incorporate using those adaptogens too. Now, my favorites are rhodiola and cordyceps. I end up using a lot of those in the clinic. And of course, we use a lot of adrenal B complex, which contains rhodiola, Panax ginseng, and the ashwagandha, along with a whole host of B vitamins, which help feed the adrenal glands, which of course take the brunt and interpret how your brain is telling your body to respond to that stress. So think about using some of those, or of course, any of the other adaptogens. You've got a lot of them to choose from. I think they'll help benefit you in your everyday life, and also, of course, in your life as an endurance athlete. So if you enjoyed the video and found it useful, please give me a like. Please subscribe to our channel. And of course, please share the video with your endurance buddies or somebody you know who's stressed out all the time. The adaptogens are a really good way to go and will help decrease your stress.